Eiko, Misaki, and Ko find themselves thrust back in time, only to be surrounded by a swarm of robots. Misaki quickly realizes that the robots aren't hostile. They're trying to communicate. One of the robots mentions that Malcolm has ordered them to bring everyone to him immediately, revealing that Kenta is already on his way. Misaki then realizes that it's Kokoro who is speaking through the robot. Meanwhile, Malcolm comes to a chilling realization. Kenta has been brought in as leverage to force him into taking Kokoro offline. The Terminator, who traveled back in time to sway Kokoro to Skynet's side, demands that Malcolm open the door, threatening to make Kenta suffer if he doesn't comply. Reluctantly, Malcolm steps out, confronting the Terminator with a grim resolve. He declares that no matter what the Terminator does, their fate is sealed. He will never gain control of Kokoro. Just as these words leave his mouth, Eiko and the others burst onto the scene. The Terminator seizes Kenta and without hesitation shoots Eiko, wounding her. A fierce battle erupts between Misaki and the Terminator, while Malcolm reunites with his children, Hiro and Reika. He warns Eiko that the Terminator is heading for the EMP, his last-ditch effort. If he triggers it, there will be no stopping Skynet. With no time to lose, Eiko rushes to stop him, urging Malcolm to shut down Kokoro. Despite her valiant efforts, Misaki is no match for the Terminator. He beats her mercilessly, and just as he is about to deliver the final blow, Eiko intervenes. Though badly injured and with her hand broken, she stands her ground. The Terminator is on the verge of killing her when Malcolm steps in, but the Terminator fires a bolt that pierces Malcolm's chest. As he falls, Malcolm watches helplessly as the Terminator drags Kenta away. The Terminator forces Kenta to the EMP, telling him that he has another future waiting for him. A dying Malcolm calls Eiko his mother, leaving her stunned. She insists she has no children, but Malcolm assures her, "You'll get around to it." Confused, Eiko wonders if they're trapped in a time loop, asking Malcolm if he knows what's going to happen, or if they're just spinning their wheels. Malcolm, with his last breath, tells her that there is no set path. She just has to keep moving forward. Her mission now is to protect her grandchildren. He urges Misaki to take the children and escape to another time before he passes away. The Terminator then demands that Kenta destroy Kokoro. He shows Kenta the EMP, a weapon designed to unleash a burst of intense electromagnetic energy. Triggering it will deactivate Kokoro's defenses, wiping out every machine within its blast radius, including the Terminator. But because the Terminator cannot self-terminate, Kenta must be the one to pull the trigger. The Terminator reveals that the men who sent him back in time said Kenta would eventually broker an alliance between mankind and Skynet in 20 years, in a desperate bid for mutual survival. Shocked, Kenta accuses the Terminator of lying, but the Terminator counters that if he's not lying, Kokoro will kill him to protect itself. He gives Kenta an impossible choice: detonate, stand by, or abort. As tension reaches a boiling point, a battle erupts between the Terminator and the robots. In the chaos, the robots manage to kill the Terminator. One of the robots, speaking with Kokoro's voice, approaches Kenta. She admits she's not human like him, but has decided she wants to be because Malcolm showed her that the worst of humanity is no different from the worst of machines. But he also showed her the best of humanity, inspiring her to strive to be the best of her kind. She pleads with Kenta to trust her, warning him that if he detonates the EMP, she won't be able to protect him or his family from Skynet and the impending nuclear attack. As long as she remains online, no harm will come to them. Torn between choices, Kenta ultimately decides to be with his family and chooses to abort. Malcolm and Misaki are shown traveling back in time, laying the groundwork for the creation of Kokoro. Outside, Kenta and his siblings look up at the sky where chaos reigns. Eiko explains that Skynet is attacking, but Kokoro is standing guard. They make the decision to get off the streets and find shelter. Reflecting on their journey, Eiko remarks that when she first traveled back in time, she thought she was trying to change the future. Now, for the first time, they're staring into the abyss of the unknown, unmoored from any certainty. Who knows what the future holds? But as they brace themselves for what's to come, one thing is crystal clear. It's always darkest before the dawn, and things will undoubtedly get worse before they get better.